Let's ask her if she wants to meet me tonight.
Why would I care about meeting you? What could possibly be interesting about our conversation?
Let's assure her that I'm a nice guy. There's no way she'll answer badly again.
You think so, don't you? Well, let's get straight to the point. I'm not interested in your niceness.
In this video, you'll learn how to build a bad girlfriend from scratch. Since building a nice assistant can be boring, we're taking a different approach this time. Unlike our previous Jarvis implementation, we'll build everything using local resources, so the solution runs entirely on your machine, without additional costs and ensuring 100% privacy. For this, we'll use the current number one ranking text-to-speech solution on Hugging Face and combine it with an uncensored version of Llama 3. When you interact with this girlfriend, the prompt is sent to your local Llama 3 server for processing. The result is then converted to speech by the TTS Deep Learning Toolkit. Why opt for an open source solution? In our previous videos, we've built similar solutions with remote language models like our Jarvis and the GPT-4 girlfriend. While these models offer impressive low latency, each call can incur costs, and there's uncertainty about what happens with our data. By using self-hosted LLMs, you avoid paying for subscriptions or API call charges. Additionally, with proprietary LLMs, you're at the mercy of the provider's pricing changes. With new models like Llama 3, we have excellent small models that can run on most machines. When we combine this with multimodal models for text-to-speech, we can create exceptional experiences for ourselves and our clients, all while having a lot of fun in the process.
Don't waste my time with small talk.
In my opinion, 11Labs still sounds a bit better. Check out this demo where it uses my trained voice. This is a 11Labs demo. Okay, that's unfair because I'm using 11Labs for my videos.
But to keep it fair, I must say that the open source voices come close, and open source solutions provide cost-free, highly customizable alternatives that run locally, ensuring complete control over your data.
Do you know LM Studio? This video assumes you know how to install models locally. If you haven't done it yet, please check out our video on how to install local models easily. We have a complete section on running Llama 3 with LM Studio. But without further ado, let's start building our bad girlfriend. So, first we need to choose a suitable model. For this, we go to Models and select the text-to-speech category. And here we see Koki ranking number one. That sounds good, and that's what we'll take. But before we can try it out, we have to create a virtual environment to keep the dependencies cleanly separated. We activate it and install TTS. The TTS library from Koki provides all the necessary tools for advanced text-to-speech generation. Now we can test it with the command TTS and the string "This is a test." We see that the result is saved in the output WAV file. Let's take a listen.
This is a test.
Now we want to try another model, namely the English model Jenny. There are numerous TTS models available, including one that can speak 13 languages. I'm curious to hear how the Jenny model sounds. We press play.
This is a test.
Okay, I like it much better already. Next, we create a fileapp.py. And here, I paste the code we need to achieve the same result using Python code. We first import the TTS class from the TTS library, which enables us to convert text into speech. I use a MacBook Studio and don't have a strong GPU. If you have one, you should change the device to CUDA. Then, we initialize the Jenny TTS model and generate an audio file named test.mp3 from the text, "I really like your new style." We try it. Okay, and I'm curious about the result. We see that a new file, test.mp3, has been created. Later, we'll add a helper method to play it automatically. Let's play it.
I really like your new style.
That sounds very good. As the next step, we now want to connect our local model, and for this, we use a server provided by LM Studio. For this, we start the server, and we can directly copy the example code. And here we paste the example code now. Let's move to import statement to the top. And we have a missing dependency. We need to install OpenAI. Let's have a look at what the pasted example code from LM Studio does. First, we start by creating a completion request using the client object. Next, we specify the model we want to use for our chat. Then, we define the messages to be used in the chat. The system message sets the behavior, telling the model to always answer in rhymes. The user message asks the model to introduce yourself. But instead of having the model answer in rhymes, we want it to adopt a dark persona. You are a female character with a dark persona. You are intelligent, resourceful, and have a sharp wit. Your demeanor is often cold, and you are not afraid to be blunt or rude. Okay, I think we will experience some surprises with the generated answers. And as a user prompt, we want to use our respective input. For this, we use Python's input command and save the user's input in the variable user prompt. We then want to store the result of the chat completion in a variable. However, for this, we only need the content of the message. We save this in the variable answer. And now we replace the text to be converted into speech with this variable. And importantly, we change the file format of the generated file to a WAV file instead of an MP3, as our PlaySound method, which we will use later, can process this better. We try it out and say hi, then I'm curious about the answer. Okay, that was exciting. She definitely has a sunny disposition.
What do you want? Don't waste my time with small talk.
Good, now we grab the method from our last project that is able to play files. We go to the GitHub organization of AIfordevs.com to find the source code for the GPT-4 video. If you don't have access yet, check out the links in the descriptions. The copied play audio method can play any sound file directly. For this, we need to import and install Pygame. We call the play audio method with the corresponding output wave file. And we install Pygame so that the dependency is met. We call it again and ask, "Do you like me?"
I don't give a damn about you.
Okay. So, next we want to have a conversation and multiple iterations. For this, we wrap the entire code in a while true loop. This should already feel like a real conversation. Keep in mind that we are building a pretty basic MVP here in just a few minutes. The objective is not to have a production-ready AI solution. But if you're curious about how to improve it further with memory and access to your emails and documents, consider starting a free trial at AIfordevs.com.
What do you want?
Let's ask her if she wants to meet me tonight.
Why would I care about meeting you? What could possibly be interesting about our conversation?
Let's assure her that I'm a nice guy. There's no way she'll answer badly again.
You think so, don't you? Well, let's get straight to the point. I'm not interested in your niceness. What do you want from me?
If you like this video, check out the most entertaining AI engineer courses on the internet at AIfordevs.com.